When President Obama was elected in 2008, he vowed that he would close Guantanamo Bay within a year.
There we go.
7 years later, that has not happened. Why is Guantanamo Bay, despite the efforts of the administration, still open? Well, let's start from the beginning. The Guantanamo facility is rented from the Cubans and was normally used as sort of a naval and Coast Guard base for the United States. When we went to war against Afghanistan in 2002, soldiers were picking up what were called men who were unlawful combatants, who were picked up on the battlefield. And they were sent to Guantanamo in sort of a hastily arranged agreement so that they might be processed while there. Well, they weren't processed, they stayed there. And they stayed there and they stayed there. Over the course of the war on terror, close to 1,000 men have been detained at Guantanamo Bay. Bad things have happened on Guantanamo Bay. Torture, interrogation, long-term captivity, men who are held without access to courts. So over the course of the war on terror, much has changed about how we think about Guantanamo Bay. Well, those who would want to close it raise three main reasons why we should end that chapter of the war on terror. First is cost. It may seem base to discuss money during national security debates, but Guantanamo Bay is very, very expensive. There are less than 100 men now detained there. It costs more to have them on Guantanamo Bay than it would if those men were being detained in a maximum facility in the United States. But of course, it's not just about money. It is also about effectiveness. No new people have been put on Guantanamo Bay for the last several years. The war on terror has changed. The zone of conflict has changed. But the third reason, and the one that most people hear about why we should close Guantanamo Bay, is because it doesn't represent America's sense of justice or America's commitment to the rules of war that we want other countries to abide by. And though there may be very strong reasons to close Guantanamo Bay, it's just simply not easy. And despite all of the efforts of the present administration to bring the number down and try to get other countries to take their citizens back, it could be that despite all those efforts, that the next president will inherit Guantanamo Bay on day one.